If you're using email to build your business, I want you to stop worrying about the open rate right now. What's up, everybody? Ricky Carruth here. Welcome back to my channel. Today, we're going to talk about open rates in email, why they do not matter. Since 2007, I've been sending a weekly email every single Wednesday to my entire database. That's every single Wednesday since 2007 through everything, through market crashes, through hurricanes, through me changing companies, through vacations, through all the weird moments in my life that I could have just said, you know what? I just don't feel like sending this weekly email this week. Okay, but I sent it anyway. It's been consistent. And what the weekly email does is it shows my clients how dependable, professional, consistent, hardworking, knowledgeable that I am. It does all the heavy lifting for me to build that relationship deeper. I get phone calls all the time from people that say, I've been getting your email for 5, 6 years, 8 years, and I'm ready to do this. I'm ready to do that. Okay, it works. And you can ask any of my 10,000 coaching clients in the Zero to Diamond free real estate coaching program if it works, okay? Because it's working for them. I've only been coaching for 2 years now, and there's clients that I have in the coaching program that are absolutely crushing it with this system. It creates a snowball for you. It allows you to scale your business. What I want to do for you right now is there's a link in the description. It's at constantcontact.com/ZTD. for Zero to Diamond. And what it is it's Constant Contact. It's the company that I use to send my weekly email. You can start a free trial. They will also give you the same exact template that I use in my weekly emails. And there's a link within the link that goes directly to my latest ebook, How I Make $1 Million a Year Using Email. So one of the biggest questions that I get and a lot of the comments that I see in the Facebook group is about open rate. They tell you what their open rate is. They want to know if that open rate is good or bad. They want to know what your open rate is. And everybody's talking about open rates, okay? Everybody is focused on open rates. And I'm here to tell you right now that open rates are only half the story, okay? Open rates are only half the story. Here's the other half, okay? Example, I send my weekly email out to over 12,000 people every week. 2,500 of those people open it up every week, okay? Pretty good open rate, right? Right, but the reason that I'm not worried about the open rates because on top of the 2,500 that open it up every week, what's even more interesting to me is the other 2,500 people that saw it in their inbox, they're not interested in doing anything right at the moment, but they see it there every single Wednesday, and they're gonna continue to see it every single Wednesday, and in 2 years, and 3 years, and 1 year, and 6 months, whenever the case may be, that they do become interested, they do become ready to do a deal, they're gonna start opening it at that point. But they saw it in their inbox every single week, and they realized just from seeing it in the inbox how consistent I was, how professional I was, right? How dependable I am. It's an extension of who I am, and it shows my clients and future customers and past clients exactly what my personality is. I'm going to be consistent for you, Mr. Client. I'm going to do what I say I'm going to do, Mr. Client. I'm going to be dependable. I'm going to be consistent. I'm going to help you. I'm going to work the hardest. I'm going to be the hardest working salesman, and I'm going to make sure everything goes good for you. That's what the email does, okay? It proves to them who you are. The open rate, 2,500 of them open it up every week, okay? That's like a 25% open rate, 20-25% open rate. But like I say, what's even farther interesting to me is that extra 20-25% that's not opening it up but sees it. What do we call that? We call that an impression, okay? Impressions are just as valuable as the opens. This goes for social media too. Everybody's so concerned with how many likes and how much engagement they're getting on their post. But I'm telling you right now, focus on the impressions as well. The engagement is great, but the impressions is more to the story, okay? Not everybody may have liked your whatever your product is or whatever you're posting about, but they saw it and they know about it. That means something, Okay, just because they didn't hit that like button or leave a comment does not mean it doesn't mean anything. So I think we're in a world that's really focused on open rates and engagement rate and all this, when we need to be not only focused on the open rate and engagement rate, but also the impressions and what that really means and the consistency of those impressions. Because someone may see a piece of content 5, 10, 15, 20, 30, 50 times before they actually engage or before they're actually interested in whatever the product is. Let's also talk about people that unsubscribe from your weekly email, okay? Because I know that stings, I know that hurts. I know a lot of people say, man, you know, I hate it. It really upsets me when somebody unsubscribes from my weekly email. You know what? It's perfectly fine that they unsubscribe, okay? You're not gonna win them all, and you gotta let people go. You have to be okay with losing some in order, in the name of producing more. Okay, let me say it again. You gotta be okay with losing some in order to produce more. What's the alternative? Not doing the weekly email, not staying in touch with your past clients and getting those referrals and the repeat business. What is the alternative? Please tell me. So the first thing I want you to get out of this is that if you're not doing the weekly email, then you're losing business right now as we speak, because there's people in your past that are thinking about doing deals, but they're not thinking about you because you're not top of their mind. You're not doing anything to follow up, to stay in touch with them forever. Now, if you're brand new, you have a really small database, and you can afford the fact that you can call all 10 past clients, 20 past clients, 30 past clients, great. But what's gonna happen when you get up to 500 past clients, 1,000 past clients, 2,000 past clients? You cannot call all those people. When you call past clients back, they wanna catch up for 30 minutes. It's not like a cold call that's gonna be, you know, 1 to 2 minutes on average. Every single past client you call is gonna wanna catch up for 10 to 30, even 40 minutes to see what's going on and really go deeper with those relationships. And what do you want to do? You want to talk back to them. You want to have those conversations. You want to go deep. But the fact is, you can't call 1,000 people like that. So you have to have something in place, and it needs to be in place now so that you can scale your business. The weekly email, like I said from the beginning, gives you an opportunity to scale your business, and it's very efficient. Okay, it doesn't matter if there's 1,000 people or 5 million people. It's still going to take you that 30 minutes a week to put it together and to get it out. So I really want you guys to take advantage of this. Reach out if you have any questions at all regarding this or anything else. Use the link below and get my template and my ebook. The ebook is really good. It's gonna go even deeper with the philosophy behind it. Also, there's a video tutorial of me creating my emails with examples of my emails on my website, zerotodiamond.com. So all this stuff is absolutely free of charge to you. I don't want a dime from you. I just want you to get out there and succeed. That's why I'm doing this. So like I said, if there's anything in the world I can do for you, please reach out. We'll talk to you guys soon.